Convicted killer Vince Marinello claims it was impossible for him to be at the scene of his wife's murder. He insists a phone call places him near Fluker, Louisiana, on his way to Mississippi. Senior investigative reporter Richard Angelico conducted the exclusive interview with Marinello.
If I had that image expert to testify for me on my behalf that that wasn't me in the parking lot, if I had the ballistics test made that Paul Fleming messed up, and if I had the test run from the scene to Fluka showing it's impossible to get there from 410 to 516, I'd have walked out the court a free man and we wouldn't be having this conversation right now.
Vince Marinello maintains he is innocent, despite a jury finding the circumstantial evidence against him overwhelming. Marinello blames his lawyers for not punching holes in the prosecution's case in three major areas. For example, these pictures showing the killer in the parking lot on Metairie Road and Marinello in the lobby of the DA's office were used by prosecutors to convince the jury they were the same man, Vince Marinello. Prosecutors used the pictures, but no expert to testify they were the same man.
That was all the more reason why we should have had an image expert. Somebody to get up there and say, there's no doubt in my mind that that's not Vince Marinello. Or at worst, say, well, I can't say it is, but I can't say it isn't. I mean, either way, I'm going to come out a winner with the jury.
Second is the gunpowder residue found in Marinello's car. Prosecutors use it to effectively paint a picture of Marinello as the gunman. But Marinello says the gunpowder was not from the .38 used to murder his wife, but from test firing a 9mm pistol he had bought for self-protection.
And they had a ballistics expert to say that, hey, the gunpowder in his car was a result of Vince test firing his 9mm in the back of the trailer and getting in his car. It would have given the jury an alternative reason to believe, well, the gunpowder in the car comes from him test firing his 9mm. Without that ballistics test, you know, the implication was, well, he shot his wife and that's where the gunpowder came from.
Liz Marinello was killed about 4:10 p.m. on a busy holiday weekend. 66 minutes later, prosecutors say a cell phone tower detected Vince Marinello's phone at Fluker, Louisiana, 80 miles away from the scene of the crime. Marinello claims that proves he is innocent.
I tell people that it is impossible to be at the scene of the crime at 4:10 and be in Fluker, Louisiana at 5:16. That's what I tell them.
According to Marinello, he left his Lakeview home at 3:30 and drove the speed limit to Fluker. That would have placed him there about 5:16. As a condition of doing this interview, he asked we drive from Metairie Road to Fluker, leaving at 4:10 and driving the speed limit.
All right, the clock says 4:10, so we're going to head out.
Our route took us down Metairie Road in heavy traffic to Airline Highway, then to I-10 via the airport and on to Interstate 55. The entire route, we drove the speed limit. Can it be done in 66 minutes?
All right, we're approaching the Fluker exit here in Tangipahoa Parish. It's 5:55, and it took us an hour and 45 minutes to get from 401 Metairie Road to the Fluker exit here in Tangipahoa Parish.
Driving the speed limit, it is impossible to get the Fluker in 66 minutes. But who besides Marinello can say he drove the speed limit?
Absolutely. First of all, as I told you, in the state of Louisiana, I had two outstanding traffic warrants out for me because of failure to pay speeding tickets. I hadn't quite taken care of them yet. One was in Jefferson Parish, one was in East Baton Rouge Parish. So whenever I was driving in the state of Louisiana, I always drove either the speed limit or a mile under it so as not to attract any traffic cop problems.
But if Marinello was in Fluker at 5:16, how does he explain getting to Byram, Mississippi, 99 miles away, by 6:15?
Once I crossed the state line in the Mississippi, yeah, I opened that baby up 90, 95 miles an hour.
We contacted one of Marinello's attorneys, Paul Fleming, for comment on this story. He declined to be interviewed, saying it would not be ethical for him to do so. Marinello's other attorney, Lee Faulkner, is now a judge and is out of town and unavailable for comment. We also requested an interview with the district attorney's office. They also declined to be interviewed while Marinello's appeal is pending. Norman and Chris,